Paul. McKinnon softly to Landeskog. And back for Bo Byram on the backhand. Vasilevsky held the post. Free puck to Chuskin. Great pressure by Colorado. Time for the game time goal. Vasilevsky stopped it. And Landeskog lost it. And Palat just wanted to send it all the way down as that bunch was out there for, on average, about a minute and a half. And they'll have to stay out. Some of them with their hands on their knees because of the icing call.
And so Colorado gets a change. They want to move the faceoff over to the right of Vasilevsky. This is an exhausted group of Tampa Bay Lightning. And so Nick Paul, dead tired, is going to have to take the draw. This is his weak side. It's hard to draw it on your backhand on this side of the ice. He'll go against Mikko Rantanen here.
Then you're wondering, you can't use your timeout after that icing. Even if John Cooper wanted to, he can't. Now they get a whistle as the puck dribbled in to Vasilevsky.
Tied 2-2 with some really good forecheck pressure. We're going to see the Lightning take the lead as Andre Palat takes the pass from Victor Hedman, 11th of the playoffs.
Andre Palat, the goal is 11th of these playoffs. His 7th in the third period. That's tied for the most by any player the last 25 years. With four others. 3:33 to go.
Interesting with Stamkos' line on the ice, but this is an offensive zone faceoff. Colorado goes with Compher, O'Connor, and Helm here. Setting things up in the last 3.5. At what time do you want your goalie out? And you want to make sure your top guys are rested and ready to go for that.
Faceoff won by Tampa Bay. Nick Paul got to center ice, dumped it in. That line goes off. Byram for Helm. Darren Helm got it in behind Vasilevsky. 3:15 to go in the third period. 3-2, Tampa Bay trying to force game 6. Back in Tampa. Played up by Taves to O'Connor. They'll try to get their big guns back out there soon. Helm sent it around. Compher working hard to get it back, as is O'Connor, but they can't keep it in. Backed out by Belmar. Here comes some line changes, and here comes McKinnon.
Okay, guys, this is too many men on the ice on Colorado. Corey Perry calls this penalty. He's standing right beside me. He was screaming as McKinnon comes off the bench. He's screaming, too many men, too many, and the call
Colorado
is made.
Minor, too many men on the ice.
Wow.
This is on Perry right here. I don't know if he's got a career in being a linesman later on, but he's got this one right. Watch McKinnon coming off the bench. There's the 6. And because McKinnon is going to take this puck, he's so far into the middle of the play. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's actually 7 until the change. And there's McKinnon. It's the correct call. Oh, what a time for this for Colorado as they try to get the equalizer. Now Tampa can put this to bed with a power play goal.
And it comes on the heels of what unfolded at the end of game 4 when Nazem Kadri scored the overtime goal to win it for Jared Bednar and the Avalanche. John Cooper said after the game, intimated in his initial press briefing that Colorado had too many men on the ice. He still maintains that they did, but he understands it's a gray area so often in hockey about line changes, but no gray area there.
Now, the only difference was Tampa didn't have 7 guys on the ice that time either.
Remember, Jared Bednar, he wants a replay. He thought Tampa Bay had 7 on to his 6. So it's a power play for Tampa Bay. At the very least, they'll want to keep the puck at this end of the rink and kill off time, already leading 3-2. 2.5 minutes to go. Kucherov. Rally being served by Alex Newhook. Hedman steps into one. Rebound free. After the stop by Kemper, Corey Perry. Rather Palat at the top of the crease. Couldn't put it back on net.
Interesting. Tampa's got 4 forwards on the ice here, even though it's a power play.
Kucherov not in a big hurry. Fed Hetman. Down to 2 minutes left in the third period. A minute 17 on the penalty for too many men, and Hetman's flip deflected out of the rink by Nico Sturm.
Victor Hetman can really load it up here. He's going to get the one-timer opportunity, and he takes it right through the Palat screen. And Palat tries to kick this with his right foot over to his backhand. Terrific play. Kemper makes a nice stick play to push it aside. John Cooper waits a little bit, delays a little bit, and then uses his timeout. So Tampa now talking on the bench here. Jeff Halpert's doing a lot of the talking. John Cooper and Derek Lalonde sitting at the back. One thing they'll want to determine is whether they want to continue with the four forwards and Victor Hedman, or if they want to get Sergachev out there with Hedman as well. They're also making sure the guys know there's 75 seconds left in this power play. Do not, at any circumstance, get stuck at the end of this with four forwards on the ice. Everybody's clear. Colorado's making sure they've got their guys on the ice. And they're waiting closer to the end of this penalty to get MacKinnon and Makar out on the ice in particular. Well, they're going to get they might get Makar out now. No, they're going to wait one more moment with him.
Face off to Kemper's right. Helm and Paul. It's still three of the dot. Set behind the net by Palat. Swept away by Kemper. Taves stepped in front of Palat. He still managed to get it back for Hetman. One timer. Nice save by Kemper. Off the shot from the circle by Stamkos. Paul behind the net. Still 55 seconds on the penalty. Committing 3-2. They have not trailed tonight. Hetman. Not in any big hurry. Nor is Stamkos. Hedman lets one rip, wide rebound, Kucherov, and it was deflected by Kemper, up out of the ring. So 38 seconds on the power play for the Lightning and a minute 20 of the third period.
There's that last play, as you mentioned, Sean. Pretty deliberate puck movement for the Hedman one-timer, and then Kemper reads that off the inboards to make the stop. Off of Nikita Kucherov, who's had a strong game. A goal on the power play in the second period. Remember, we talked in the open. What's the keys for Tampa Bay? They wanted to get a push early, get to the first TV timeout. Done. They needed a big night from Vasilevsky. Done. They needed to win the special teams battle. They've done that too. They're now 80 seconds away from pushing this back to Tampa.
Well, as we said, it looked like so much was worthy against them coming into this game. Vasilevsky a little casual at the side of the net. With a forechecker approaching. Stamkos back into the zone. We're ticking down to 1 minute to go in game five. 15 seconds on the power play. Here's Kucherov top of the circle. Has it back from Sergachev. Penalty's up in 5 seconds. Hetman from a tough angle. Off the arm of Kemper. The penalty has expired. They'll try to establish the zone and get Kemper out for the extra attacker. Newhook does that. Dumps it in deep. The net is empty for Colorado. 30 seconds to go in game five. Knocked out of the air by Makar. Not cleared. Kept in by Rantanen. Rantanen powers. Sends it down low. Off Lehkonen into the corner. 18 seconds to go. Makar up high. Off it goes to the side. Set down low by Landeskog. Center. And it was behind Lehkonen. 8 seconds to go. Makar just didn't keep it in. Beautiful stop by Vasilevsky. And now they're waving it down for offside. He did not keep it in at the line.
They'll rerun the clock to make sure it's at the right time. But the offside called here is the pass is fanned onto Makar. You see it clearly outside the line. The faceoff will come outside the line. As Tampa off the deck here in a game that looks completely stacked against them. 6 seconds away from going home again. against St. Louis. Colorado led 3-1, lost game 5 here, and had to go on the road for game 6.
Off the faceoff, 3 seconds, and the play's offside again. Ray, this is a Tampa Bay bench, a team that has accomplished so much over the last 3 years, and John Cooper continually talks about their competitive spirit, their complete will to win, and how proud he is of this bunch. And I'd imagine if they took off these 3 seconds and win, he's never been prouder, given what they're up against here tonight.
He talked so much, as you mentioned this morning, about the heart and the guts and the determination, and they hang by a thread sometimes, and here they are. It's going back to Tampa.
Andre Palat, another game-winning goal in the playoffs. And Tampa Bay behind Vasilevsky has forced the game 6. This series now 3-2 in favor of the Avalanche, denied in their bid to win the Stanley Cup tonight on home ice, and this really tightens things up considerably as the series shifts back to Tampa, Florida.
One of Tampa's heroes through this playoff is a 7th-round draft pick. 208 in his draft here is Andre Palat. He's got goals in game 1 here, a sweet feed from Kucherov going to the net. Game 3 is Stamkos, and he doesn't miss. And here in game 5, tied 2-2. Nice work, Sergachev, Hedman, and the one-timer squeaks through Darcy Kemper. And Andre Palat, who scored late before in the Ranger series, does it again tonight. And Tampa pushes this back home.
Talking about game-winning goals with Andre Palat.
That's right. Andre, I'm just curious, how did your team win this game?
I mean, I thought we played a good game. Great road game. We're staying on top of it. Vasi was great again. And we just find a way to win. So huge win. Now we're excited to go back to Tampa.
You have a knack for scoring these big late clutch goals. Why?
I don't know. I mean, that was a great play by the whole line. Hedy find me, and I had an open net, and I was just lucky enough went in. So, I was really happy.
Last game was such an emotional ending. How are you feeling afterwards?
Right now we feel pretty good. We're excited to go back in front of our friends, and it's gonna be a great game.
How were you feeling before this game?
I felt great. Everybody was pretty confident, excited, and we knew we had to just win this game and move on.
And what were your thoughts when they got a late, too many men on the ice penalty?
Not much. I mean, I was just happy we're gonna have a PP and make sure we're not gonna, you know, do some mistakes, and we did great.
We'll see you Sunday. Dekuye.
Yes, bye-bye.
Final score in game 5 here.